to our Man in the Painter's Room, presented by our 7th and 8th graders. I'm very proud of everything that they've accomplished, and I can't wait for you to see the show. As we start everything here at UW, let's quiet ourselves for prayer. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, amen. Lord, thank you for creation itself and the incredible gifts and talents you so genuinely entrust to me. May I appreciate and develop these talents, always recognizing that they come from you and remain yours. Guide me in using them for the benefit of everyone that I touch, so that they may be more aware of your creative presence and develop the creativity entrusted to them for the good of others. Help me also to use your talents to bring a creative spark and new possibilities to your world, living out my call to be an integral part of your creation. Amen. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Enjoy the show.
And Vincent believed painting should come from nature. To win this argument, Vincent cut off his own ear and gave it to Paul. Soon after this, Vincent signed himself to the mental asylum in St. Remy, France. Vincent so eloquently said, "It is good to love many things, for therein lies the true strength. And whosoever loves much performs much and can accomplish much."
Thank you. This is Van Gogh's been looking for a place he can find himself. A place where young artists can thrive and enjoy their life. Hopefully, this will be the place. Van Gogh made friends too, like this man, Paul Gauguin, a fellow artist. At first, all is at peace. They paint together and spend time together. But after a while, their words turn to fiery spikes against each other.
Vincent, haven't you ever thought about painting what's on your mind? Don't you know a wolf has turned ugly? So there's any beauty in it? Any poetry in it anymore?
No, Paul. I see beauty all around me in the world you call ugly. I paint the beauty I see in it, and believe me, there is so much beauty.
You are truly a fool. You call me a fool just because I choose to see beauty in the world? Because I have hope for this community of artists?
This place will never be an honest community.
No artist will come to live here.
Vincent, I don't know what you're thinking. There is no one here that feels the way you do, that sees what you see.
Honestly, Vincent, there is no beauty left to paint. Why can't you just be honest with yourself and paint how you really feel on the inside?
Paul, you couldn't possibly think this way.
I mean, how?
You'll always be alone in your ways of thinking, Vincent, in this ugly, ugly world.
This argument was too much for Vincent. His mind had taken too much. His demons were with him everywhere he went, overwhelming him. Van Gogh realized that he needed help, that he needed to feel better. He admitted himself to St. Paul's Asylum in May of 1889. He spent his time there focusing on himself and painting famous works of art. No one really understood that painting was his escape, that it was the one thing keeping him at home, keeping him together. It was the one thing keeping his small and broken world in one piece. He spent all day and all night painting whatever came to mind, painted whatever he wanted to paint. He painted 142 total pieces of art during his stay at the asylum, and one of his most famous ones, the Starry Night.
My dear Theo, I was longing for your letter, and so I was very happy to receive it, and to see from it that you're well, as are Joe and the friends you speak of. That said, I'll tell you that we're having some superb autumn days, and that I'm taking advantage of them. I have a few studies, among others, a mulberry tree, all yellow on stony ground, standing out against the blue of the sky. And now that I'm staying on here for the time being, and will most probably spend the winter here, in the spring, in the fine season, shall I not stay here too? That will depend on my health above all. What you say about bears is nevertheless a very agreeable prospect to me, in and sooner or later that ought to be fixed without seeking further. But anyway, for the moment, there's therefore nothing that's absolutely hurrying us. I'm writing to you in haste, so as not to wait to answer your kind letter, hoping that you'll write again without delaying long. I've seen more very beautiful subjects for tomorrow, in the mountains. Kind regards to Joe and to our friends, shaking both your hands, believe me. Ever yours, Vincent.
He wasn't exactly sure where he would go. Eventually, in May of 1890, he moved to a town called Auvers-sur-Oise in southern France. Here, with the help of his trusted brother Theo, he found a nice place to live. This place is called the Revaux Inn, which has the Revaux family, a husband and wife and their two daughters, one of them named Adeline. Present himself as quiet and humble. He spent most of his time there painting the fields, admiring the beauty surrounding him. Sometimes, people who know him out there would come to speak with him. He also made friends with other artists there too, Tom and Martinez.
Tom, you're a painter. Why only focus on girls, not paint?
Focusing on what you care. You guys haven't even held a girl's head.
family too. Like this one, to his mother and sister.
Dear mother and sister, sincere thanks for your kind letters, which gave me a great deal of pleasure. For the present, I feel calmer than I did last year, and the turmoil in my head has abated so much. For my part, I'm wholly absorbed in the vast expanse of wheat fields lying against the hills, large as a sea, with delicate yellows, pale greens and purples, a plowed and weeded piece of land, speckled with the green of flowering potato plants, all under a sky of pale blue, white, pink, and violet tones. I'm entering in a mood of almost too much calm, eager to paint those fields. Your loving Vincent.
He and Adeline became. She would often go with him to paint, providing company along with the sheep.
You know, I think he's growing on me. We should call him something.
He's growing on me, too. Oh, I know what we should call him. Paul, after one of my old friends.
Fitting. Who's here?
Yeah.
What's your favorite color?
All of them, I think.
Mine's purple. I don't like orange that much, but we need orange. I suppose you're right. Is yours? How do you always know it's paint? Your paintings are always so beautiful and original.
I'm not sure. I suppose I dream my painting and then I paint my dream.
Thank you.
Van Gogh and Monsieur who made the announcement in the town hall. Their whole family was silent, as though they had lost a family member. Adeline and her sisters suffered. Everyone helped the family to prepare for Van Gogh's funeral. Tom Bergstein, for instance, picked buttery yellow flowers for the funeral. Theo had placed his paintings and works out of the room.
This is a really beautiful funeral.
It really is stunning. They're sweet.
Van Gogh had a beautiful life and beautiful art. He painted over 900 paintings. His room at the inn was never rented out again and remains vacant to this day. Everyone always missed him and thought about him. This is displayed in an excerpt from a letter from painter Emile Bernard, sent to poet Albert Aurier about Van Gogh.
My dear Aurier, your absence from Paris means I have not heard the dreadful news, which, however, I'm obliged to tell you without delay. My dear friend Vincent died 4 days ago. The sun was terribly hot outside. We climbed the hillside outside our rooms after we talked about it, about the daring impulse of the famous art, the great project he was always working on, and the good he had done to all of us. That is quite enough, my dear Aurier. Quite enough, don't you think? Rather sad. You know how much I loved him, and can imagine how much I left. You are his critic, but don't forget him. Try in a few words to tell everyone that you know he is a finale. Truly worthy of his great spirit and incredible talent. My heartfelt wishes.
Today, Vincent is known as one of the greatest painters in the world, despite the fact that he did not become well-known until after his death. Art historians view Vincent as a modern professional, not a tortured hero. His paintings showed perfection out of imperfection. Because of this, his bold color, and emphasized brush work, he has left a major footprint in the modern world of art. Some of his most famous artworks include Starry Night, his Sunflowers, and Self-Portraits. In the words of Vincent Van Gogh, what would life be if we had no courage to attempt it?
As well as many of our props. And then the
they wrote the script. So I am so proud of them. And I just, so let's hear it for all the seventh and eighth graders.